Welcome. We come to you near the Willowbrook Mall in Wayne, New Jersey, where once again, it's time to shake things up. You know, this Labor Day, and every Labor Day, provides us with a golden opportunity for us to take a break from the daily grind and truly relish the fruits of our delicious labor that go way beyond fruit. And for those who have hobbies that don't require as much labor, like this one, YouTubing, today provides us a chance to really take things a little more casually than we already do. And trust me, they don't get any more casual or more delicious than the Shake Shack, despite it being my first time coming to a Shake Shack. But regardless, if you've been craving to bring a taste of Shake Shack home on a budget, the crave stops and starts here. Next. Shake Shack kitchen, and this is actually the self-service kiosk. It says here to place your order, enter your phone number, and they'll text you when your order is ready. Well, here's the deal. I do have a phone, two in fact, but my main phone number right now is out of service because the main phone can't be paid until a few months later. Then that's kind of a bummer, so I don't know how I'm going to proceed with this. But while I figure that out, why don't you learn more about this cookbook, Shake Shack Recipes and Stories, co-authored by CEO Randy Garuti, culinary director Mark Mulzati, with an introduction by founder Danny Meyer. It was picked up for 25% off the price of $3.99. It is a Clarkson Prada publication, which retails for $26 in the U.S. and $35 in Canada. And by the way, this is actually a signed copy. You see the original location here, we opened it up at Madison Square Park in New York, which was where they had their big book signing. I can only imagine what that was like, knowing that this is an autographed copy.
Shake Shack began right here as a hot dog cart in 2001. And we never dreamed that 3 years later we would birth the original Shake Shack. And after that, we sure never dreamed there would ever be a second location, let alone where we've gotten to today. Hi, I'm Randy Garuti, and I'm the CEO of Shake Shack.
Let's get some books going here. You guys need a book? Come on now.
The Shack Book is a collection of stories and recipes all about Shake Shack and how we went from one location in New York City in Madison Park to over 130 all around the world. I'm Mark Rosati, culinary director of Shake Shack. I'm really excited to finally share the recipe of the Shack Burger. I think what's fantastic about it is it's all about simplicity and using the best ingredients possible.
When this happens, good things are happening right here. In the book, we talk a lot about what it means to stand for something good. And what that means is in everything we do, in everything we build here at Shake Shack, we think about how can we have a little less impact on the earth that we live in. How can we be a little bit better for our community, for our team?
Is the secret Shack sauce recipe in the book? I'll tell you what, make our recipe, then go to a Shake Shack and try the sauce there, and then you tell me.
What's cool about this particular Shake Shack is that this has outdoor patio seating. How neat is that? I mean, on a warm summer's day, how can we not take advantage? I know I'm about to do so right now by taking a look inside Shake Shack Recipes and Stories with the cool summer breeze serving as the soundtrack. By the way, I got some additional info about this particular copy from one of the servers, Eric. He told me that this is actually a former manager's copy, Ronak Patel. He was the manager of one of the Shake Shacks around here. Not this one, but one of the other Shake Shacks in Jersey. And he got this signed by Danny Meyer, the founder, and Randy, the CEO. How cool is that? What we're going to do in this review is highlight five recipes. Four quintessential Shake Shack menu items that you can find on their YouTube channel. And of course, I'll link all of those videos below, as well as the Shake Shack story video. As a matter of fact, you actually see three of those quintessential recipes on the cover. Additionally, as a matter of fact, I ordered one of those things. the chicken sack. It's actually the avocado bacon sack. And it looks, it smells insanely delicious. Kind of small, but good. I also ordered a 6-piece chicken bite, so let's have a look at that. A little dark, a little crunchy, little KFC-esque, but it should taste good. Anyway, before we dig in, let's dig into this book first. We begin with the anatomy of a shake burger. You'll find these 2-page anatomy sections detailing all the various components that go into making their quintessential menu items here, such as the shack burger, the one that started a revolution at Madison Square Park. You gotta have the best potato buns. These are Martin's potato rolls, unsalted butter, green leaf lettuce, a salt and pepper house blend, ground beef, American cheese, Roma tomatoes, and the secret shack sauce. And did you know it takes 45 seconds for the cheese to melt on an average shack burger? Like this one photographed masterfully by Christopher Husmer and her team, I might add? Ah, yeah. So here we have making a shack burger. Step-by-step photographic elements teaching you how to make a classic shack burger. We have a dual-page recipe photograph and the recipe itself on page 48, along with recipes for the secret shack sauce, or at least the variation that's close enough, on page 49. Along with variations such as the peanut butter bacon burger and the smoked shack, among other variations for the other quintessential menu items in here, including this breakfast shack burger, the classic egg and cheese. We also have a variation with sausage that you can see right here. I believe that's at Grand Central Terminal that they photographed that particular shot. Now you know me, I'm a sucker for anything that has celebrity chefs in it, so how could I not highlight the chef collab in here? A few culinary evidences in and out of the television world contribute their Shake Shack favorites, such as David Chang's Momofuku Shrimp Stack. And in saying that, I should also say, there's actually a Surf and Turf Shack Burger in here, fusing lobster meat with their classic ground beef burger. Daniel Balut has his Piggy Shack, which piles on the barbecue sauce. Daniel Hum has his Hum Burger. And Andrew Zimmern of Bizarre Foods on Travel Channel has his Cabrito Butter Burger, which features goat. Oh yeah, this book gets a little exotic with the celebrity chefs. Massimo Bottura contributes his Emilia Burger, an homage to Italy, with salsa verde and balsamic mayo. By the way, this burger, because it's named Emilia, is laced with Parmigiano Reggiano. And this is Pat LaFreda's burger of his dreams. You know, the master butcher is actually one of the master meat makers for Shake Shack. Next up, the anatomy of a SHACK-CAGO dog. Once again, all of the delicious components outlined to make their SHACK-CAGO dog, because they were originally known as the little hot dog cut that could. Turning the page here, we have the makings of a SHACK-CAGO dog in action through step-by-step photographs and the recipe itself. Now to an anatomy of crinkle-cut fries. Not a lot of fuss here, not a lot of ingredients, just yellow potatoes, canola oil, and kosher salt. And a crinkle cutter, which you might have to find at a specialty food supply store. Crinkle cut fries are my favorite type of fries, by the way. I had some yesterday, actually a few days ago, that were frozen, or either, just to drop a name, so I'm not gonna do that here and be redundant. But those are crinkle cut fries. Actually, that photograph here is a variation called iris fries, topped with bacon and scallions and horseradish cream. The recipe of which you can find here. This is the anatomy of my chicken sack. Now, the basic does not have avocado or bacon, but here we have the components: buttermilk, seasoned flour, chicken breast, a buttermilk herb mayo, as you can see right here. That's gonna add some herby tang to this. Pickles, As you can also see here, one of them underneath the patty, shredded lettuce and a potato bun. Of course, that you can see right here. This is the making of the chicken shack, and of course, this is the recipe for a chicken shack. Plus, a wine pairing. Oh yeah, chicken shack and Chardonnay. Now, I don't drink, but for those who swing that way, that'll be a viable option to try. And yes, these are the chicken bites that I'm having. Turning to the next section here, we have here the opening of the first California Shake Shack. A timeline of opening, designing, constructing, and operating the West Hollywood California Shake Shack. Now you know, we are known for bringing Hollywood home on a budget, and I don't care if it's North or West Hollywood, if it says Hollywood, California, you know it's going to be featured here on TSR, especially if it comes from the thrift store. Because what is our name? Oh yeah, the Thrift Store Rundown. I'm especially fond of this. Movies Under the Stars. This was 7 weeks away from the big opening day, back in March 15th, 2016. So employees dined under the stars while watching the original Star Wars movie. And by the way, I have the two-disc New Hope soundtrack that I'll be reviewing in the near future. These recipes, these stories, these photographs, among a myriad of others, truly make this a really delicious find. And not only is it delicious, but it's also heartfelt and historic. You get a timeline of the history of the hamburger joint. Danny's Hamburger Roots, again, Danny Meyer is the founder. You get more info about how Shake Shack does business, how it went public, and how they stand for something good when it comes to teamwork, sourcing out local regional ingredients, produce, the best beef, the best chicken, the best meat in general, and so on and so forth. And it's also really heartfelt in the fact that it acknowledges its customers, its fans, and its communities. Thanks for creating the gathering place that is Shake Shack. And you saw the dedication at the end of their book signing video. Of course, you can find that here. I would read that, but you already saw it. And I am so salivating right now. If there were a few silent faces during this review, trust me, it's because I'm actually kind of drooling inside to try this. And I'm not gonna wait anymore.
Mm. Oh man.
Probably should have gotten some napkins, but that buttermilk mayo and the herby cane it provides, the avocado steaminess, the crunch of the pickle, which I'll prove in a moment. Mmm, now for the chicken bites. Let's see here. Was a nice Labor Day lunch. The avocado bacon chicken shack definitely made it worth the $15 in change alone. The chicken bites, however, are another story. They were okay, but definitely could use the condiments. And to add a relative insult to an equally non-existent injury, there's a Chick-fil-A restaurant right next door. Well, if I spot a Chick-fil-A cookbook, I'll be sure to come back and try that out. But for now, it's all about Shake Shack, and there are recipes and stories in this cookbook which definitely don't lack anywhere and anything. Yeah, you might have to go to a specialty food shop to get the crinkle cutter or the goat meat, but come on, 5 out of 5 claps easily. If you've ever been a loyal Shake Shack customer and always worried that you weren't going to be able to replicate their fine casual taste, well, my friends, shake those worries off, because now with this cookbook, shakers are going to shake in their own sacks. Having said that, haters aren't going to be hating this place because of their scrumptious service. And I definitely want to thank the fine folks here at the Willowbrook Shake Shack for their hospitality and their contribution to the production of this video. By the way, did you know that there's a Panera Bread somewhere around here in Willowbrook Rain Town Center? And there's also the Panera Bread Cookbook. Oh yeah, I'm hunting that down as we speak. Because after all, we're all about taking it up a notch all together now, shaking it up along the way. Happy Labor Day from the Thrift Store Rundown. Thanks for watching TSR. Now, to see another awesome review like this one, click here. If you want to become a Hollywood bargain hunter, click here to subscribe. And I'll catch you on the thrift side.